My dear Theo, I just sent you 3 large drawings, as well as a few more smaller ones.
Theo, my brother. Far more than my brother. Sometimes, when I was painting those pictures, I felt we were doing them together. I could never have painted them without Theo. Theo was an art dealer. He made a good living. He allowed me to devote myself entirely to my art. He sent me money, canvas, paper, tubes of paint, everything I needed to paint, to work. That was our agreement. And I produced. I felt driven to do good work. Usually I included a sketch of painting in progress in the letters I sent Theo. Then when the picture was finished, I sent it to him. And then I moved on. I set another canvas and the easel. That's what I was here for, you see? I was on this earth to paint right till the end. And in less than a century, I became a myth, when all I wanted was to become a painter. Don't think it was easy. I spent a long time finding my way. Me, the Dutchman, the preacher's son. When I was only 16, I became an art dealer in Amsterdam, London, and Paris. Then I became a preacher, like my father, in Belgium. I used to preach to the destitute, to miners and laborers. I talked to them and read them the Bible. I enjoyed it because I like people. But it didn't last. They thought I was overzealous. They thanked me and told me to go on my way. So I did the one thing I could do, the one thing I really wanted to do deep down. I drew. I was 27 by then. I varied my approaches. At first I copied works by artists I admired, Mie especially. Yes, I copied Mie a lot. Then I took the plunge. I began painting in oils. Pictures didn't just come to me at first. I worked in a very academic way. I did multiple studies to come to grips with my subject. I was moving on, step by step. But color, which made me famous later on, was still a long way off. I was still seeing darkly. In 1886, I joined Theo in Paris. I was 32 years old. I had been painting almost constantly for 4 years and already more than 200 paintings.